Okay, YouTube, I think we're just about ready here. So I had to do three adapters on this end. So this fitting here in the gas valve, it adapts M8x1 male to 1/8 inch pipe thread female. And then I have a street elbow here, which has 1/8 pipe thread male. And then it's got 1/8 pipe thread female. And then this is 1/8 pipe thread to 1/4 inch compression fitting. And I had to do this because here's the outer edge of the cooktop. So yeah, the way this is going to be installed is I'll have a concrete backer board laid on top of the concrete block here. So we'll have the concrete block, there'll be the concrete backer board, and then on top of that I'll have some clay bricks. So the rim of the cooktop will sit on top of this brick. And this, as you can see, sticks out. So I need to minimize how far out this sticks. So that was the tightest I could get it. Yeah, ideally it would have been nice if I could find an 8mm to 1/8 pipe thread elbow. I made up an 8mm copper tube there. And then on this end, I have a 1/4 inch copper tube, and then I showed you where I drilled out the ID of the 8mm tube, and then I silver soldered the 1/4 inch copper tube inside the 8mm tube with the compression fitting there. This has the ferrule up inside there, and so this guy will fit into here. And then on this end I have the 13mm tube nut with a compression fitting, and that will go in there. And I had to go back and forth quite a few times to get everything bent right. So I had to get this piece bent to fit in there, and then I also had to tighten this elbow at just the right angle, because this I don't think is a tapered fitting, it's just a straight threads. So I had to find out where this fitting tightened and then set the elbow, and then I used some rector seal gas sealant on all the threads here to get that end in. There we go. Yeah, you kind of have to work both ends in there. Okay, that thread started. Yeah, there we go. Now it fits. And I'll check for gas leaks and then see what this thing looks like now. Okay, I don't see any gas leaks there. Let's take a look at the flame. Probably can't see the flame. It's not quite dark enough yet, but really nice control. Wow, that is nice. Yeah, that's what I was looking for, was to get this knob so it wasn't just on off. You can see there, I can just go down, 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 down. Wow, that is really nice. And initially I thought I might try doing the small valve, but the tubing is so short and it's really complicated tight bend in there. And I just don't think it's really worth doing the small one. According to the gas meter, I am limiting the heat output just a little bit, so I think I'm just going to call it quits here. Yeah, so that's what I was looking for, was to get a reasonable amount of control on the flame. And I think the problem was with the supply jets, they were so small that all the restriction was in the burner, so the valve really didn't do anything. It would be full flame down until you hit the bottom, and then it would go down like that. You had that flame or you had that flame. There was nothing in the middle. In the same way on this one, you had full flame or you had minimal flame. The restriction was in the burner, not in the valve. Now the main restriction is in the valve. And there's my gas pressure right there, if we can read the meter. About 7.5 inch water column. So I have my regulator that's over there is set for the propane setting, which means that regulator will never kick in unless I get over 10-inch water column. And the meter on the side of the house is set up for about 7.5-inch. The nice thing with this setup is I don't have to change my regulator if I need to change to propane. I still have to change the jets in the two burners, but the regulator just stays on the propane setting. The grill regulator is set up for 4-inch on natural gas and then 10-inch on propane. So for the 10-inch, I'm fine. But on the natural gas, I've got to run the 4-inch water column regulator setting. So I still have to change one regulator to change fuels. Okay, YouTube, we're clocking the gas meter here again. And this is with the larger feed pipe, and it looks like right there I started the timer right when it hit that mark on the half cubic foot dial. So before it took 4 minutes to do a half cubic foot, and now it's 3 minutes and 15 seconds. Okay, YouTube, so worked out the numbers. That equals 9.2 cubic feet per hour. And if you multiply that out, it comes out to about 9,500 BTU per hour with natural gas with the burner. And before, I was getting about 7,500. So yeah, that's a really good increase. According to my gas flow chart, the computed heat would be something like 9,700 BTUs. So it's a little bit less than that, but it depends what value you use for the energy density of the natural gas. At least that's within the right ballpark. And the other thing I'm doing here is timing this boil test here. So I've got 2 quarts or about 2 liters of water plus some ham and some split peas in the pot here, just about at a boil. When I did this with the previous gas pipe, I got about a 15-minute boil time. Yeah, she's boiling now, so let's just stop that. Yeah, so we shaved a little over a minute off the boil time for a large pot here. This is the pot I mainly tried to optimize this large burner for. This is the pot that I use quite a bit. I've tried to make this large burner work better with this pot. So you can see the pot is definitely a bit oversized for this cooktop, but it works. Yeah, that looks really nice. So anyway, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.